We're here today at Griffith College, but it hasn't always been Griffith College. It has a long 200-year history. It started as Richmond Bridewell back in 1811. Now, before that, it was Grimwood Nursery, so basically a farm, but the land was purchased by Dublin Corporation back in 1811 as a prison. Now, they needed new prisons because the previous practice in the United Kingdom and Great Britain and Ireland was to transport the majority of convicts to penal colonies in places like Australia. Prior to that, even minor crimes were punished by hanging. But the new idea was that convicts would be held in prisons and they would be reformed. So on the entrance to Richmond Bridewell here, there was the motto, "Cease to do evil, learn to do well." So generations of Dubliners knew the place as the Cease to Do Evil Hotel. And the conditions were pretty harsh. What you had here was not major criminals, not in the main people who committed very serious crimes. It was a bridewell, so it was where people were held before they were taken to court on remand. It was also where people were held, again, having been convicted of relatively minor crimes like petty theft, drunkenness, affray, indebtedness in the early years, and refusal to pay fines also. Now, despite that, despite the fact that there weren't, you know, very dangerous criminals here for the most part, the conditions in the early decades of Richmond Bridewell were really very harsh. So prisoners were forbidden to talk to each other outside of exercise time. The idea was that they would reflect on their crime and they would learn to be better people. Punishments were very harsh, so there was the use of a thing called the iron helmet, where an iron helmet would be strapped on people's heads. There was the straitjacket, there was the treadmill. So not the thing that we run on in a gym today, but a punishment where you would run or walk until you couldn't anymore. There was picking oakum, you know, a very tedious task. And up until the 1860s, there was whipping. So prisoners would be whipped also for infractions. Now, we'll talk about it later in the tour, but for the most part, there were, as I said, petty criminals in the language of the day. About 3,000 people a year passed through here, but at any one time, there was only about 200 to 250. Now, the reason for that, obviously, is most of them were doing very short sentences. But there were exceptions to this, especially in later years. There were also political prisoners were held here, members of the Fenians or Irish Republican Brotherhood. And later on again, there was military prisoners. But for 80 to 90 years, this was its main role as a prison, a place of punishment run by the local authorities in Dublin for petty criminals and minor crimes. And it was known, as I said, as the Cease to Do Evil Hotel.